Hey guys, how you doing? Well, I thought I'd just do a bit of an update video because it's been a while since I've actually sat there and had a bit of a chat. And because of the last few videos, I've been working on the daily artwork series where I'm doing a drawing a day, quite random. Been using a lot of stencils for the first several, but I think I've exhausted my possibilities. Well, I haven't exhausted my possibilities, but I want to start doing something else just from using my stencils. I actually want to do some drawings now and add another interest to this daily series. But first of all, I thought I'd like to show you my second plexiglass on board that I made pretty much last night and today. I'm really happy with how it's turned out. Got a couple of little areas to clean up yet. They got little smudges of paint, but that's just minor things. Really happy with how it's turned out. I'm loving this plexiglass on board. I just buy the boards from my craft store. They're around, I don't know, here everything's expensive, so they're around 20 bucks for the board. I could make them myself, but I couldn't be bothered. Plexiglass is expensive here as well. It's like, for this piece, it's around, I don't know, 10 bucks American. So I'm really happy with how this work turned out. As you know, this was the first one. I haven't finished it yet. I'm still working on it. I put all these nails in underneath here. I don't know if you can see them. But I want to tie string around them, red string. And I might even take the nails out into the actual artwork, so it sort of ties it in. So happy with that. Going to continue on the plexiglass series on board just because I'm into that at the moment, and the craft store is actually out of the board, so I've ordered a heap in so I can continue. I want to start doing some textured ones with, you know, my textures and patterns, and combining patterns and textures together in plexi boards. These two are destined to a gallery I'm going to next week. Speaking of which, I had a phone call from two of the galleries I have my works with. One's in town and the other one's about, I don't know, 2 hours drive away, and they've completely sold out of all of my smaller works. So they're wanting more, so that's really good for me. Things are starting to move in that direction. Like, I'm starting to sell more on a regular basis as people in the local area are starting to get to know me. Of course, with me and my workshops that I'm starting to run, I've got another workshop next weekend with 10 teachers. Not 10 teachers. Well, some of them are and some of them are just artists. So I'm running another workshop. And I guess my name's getting out there because they all talk and say how good their workshop was, and, you know, I've had a few emails and a few phone calls since then asking about private tuition, one-on-one, and that sort of thing. So Norway's a pretty small country, so it doesn't take long, especially if you're an outsider, being an Australian living in Norway and doing something a bit different to what is most people do around here. So you start to stick out a bit, and that's a good thing, I guess, in a lot of ways. Still doing a bunch of works on paper. I've entered a art competition in London. It's a juried show. I don't normally enter competitions and stuff just because it's just not my thing really, but I just thought this time, why not? It was like one of those online things. It's, you pay an entrance fee, I think it was $25 or something like that. You submit an online gallery of work to them. They then jury that and decide who's going to be in the show. I don't know how many artists they're going to choose for the show. And then, basically, they narrow it down to three artists in the end, who I think will get a prize or something, I'm not too sure. But got to be in it to win it, so they say. So I decided I'm going to start trying and get into a few more competitions and see where they go. I mean, it's really hard to say, oh, what sort of work do you need to win something like an art show? But it's really hard. I've run one art competition before. And I've entered, I think, two since that time and haven't... I think I've got a, what do they call it, People's Choice Award, and the other one I didn't get anything. So there's so many factors that play into it, and it also comes down to the judges, who they are, what style of work they like, what's their criteria. I mean, they give you a basic outline and stuff, but at the end of the day, I think it's just a bunch of chance and luck and what's in at the moment in the art world, really, or what's looks interesting. So for those, I reckon, you know, competitions are a good thing in a lot of ways if you want to promote your name that way, and it's a good thing to get into magazines and stuff by that. But like I said, for me, I'll try and get in one every now and again, but there's nothing that I'm going to break my neck over. Actually, the only competition I'd really like to do one day is the Archibald Prize, and I know that's a big prestigious art competition, and you have to get someone pretty famous to sit for you, like to do a portrait. But like I said, dream big, you never know. So I mean, that's the only thing, that one of the only competition I really ever wanted to enter. I've got a book about the whole competition through all of the years that it's been running and all the winners, so you can see the progression of art and how it's changed over, you know, hundreds of years, really. Yeah, that's about it. Really just wanted to have a chat. Ning site's going fantastic. Online courses that I'm offering, they're starting really soon. With them, I'm going to be running several courses. Like, my texture and layering course is quite popular, but I'm only taking 20 people at a time, just because it's really hard to devote your time to more than that, because I'm sure you're going to get lots of questions. So I want to be able to focus on everybody, give them my full attention. So if they're paying for my online course, then you know, I want to give them 130% of my attention with what they're on, because I really want people to learn these techniques and really use them as levering tools to get them up and creating fantastic work, well, helping to enhance the work that they do already. But yeah, like I said, Ning site's fantastic. I'm meeting so many different artists. We're all collaborating. We're putting blogs, posts, people you know, asking for assistance with their work. And that's something you don't get on YouTube, as much as I love YouTube. And I know a few other artists feel the same way. So come over and check my Ning out and see what you think. Yeah, all right. That's it. Now I'm about to go and start a new drawing, and we'll see where that takes us. So have a great Sunday, and hope you have a great week. Later.